COVID-19, wearing masks, vaccines, and the theft of liberty. With the Son and in the Spirit did God project eternal Havana, and ever since has there obtained the eternal pattern of coordinated participation in creation, sharing. This pattern of sharing is the master design for every one of the sons and daughters of God who go out into space to engage in the attempt to duplicate in time the central universe of eternal perfection. Every creature of every evolving universe who aspires to do the Father's will is destined to become the partner of the time-space creators in this magnificent adventure of experiential perfection attainment. Were this not true, the Father would have hardly endowed such creatures with creative free will. Neither would he indwell them, actually go into partnership with them by means of his own spirit. Lucifer's folly was the attempt to do the non-doable, to short-circuit time in an experiential universe. Lucifer's crime was the attempted creative disenfranchisement of every personality in the system of Lanadadia, the unrecognized abridgment of the creature's personal participation, free will participation, in the long evolutionary struggle to attain the status of light and life, both individually and collectively. In so doing, this one-time sovereign of your system set the temporal purpose of his own will directly athwart the eternal purpose of God's will, as it is revealed in the bestowal of free will upon all personal creatures. The Lucifer Rebellion thus threatened the maximum possible infringement of the free will choice of the ascenders and servers of the system of Lanadadia, a threat forevermore to deprive every one of these beings of the thrilling experience of contributing something personal and unique to the slowly erecting monument to experiential wisdom which will sometime exist as the perfected system of Lanadadia. Thus does the Lucifer Manifesto, masquerading in the habiliments of liberty, stand forth in the clear light of reason as a monumental threat to consummate theft of personal liberty, and to do it on a scale that has been approached only twice in all the history of Nebadon. In short, what God had given men and angels, Lucifer would have taken away from them. That is, the divine privilege of participating in the creation of their own destinies and of the destiny of this local system of inhabited worlds. No being in all the universe has the rightful liberty to deprive any other being of true liberty, the right to love and be loved, the privilege of worshiping God and of serving his fellows.